Picking a program is tough, but just imagine yourself living somewhere and practicing somewhere for 4 years. So somewhere that you can see yourself thrive and kind of sustain your own interests outside of work as well.
Knowing that I was going somewhere where the people in general were people I could work with every day, somewhere that I felt like I was really advancing myself, to me would be the most important factors in deciding on a place to go.
What was really important that I didn't notice as an applicant, but now that I do looking back, is noticing how happy the people are at the place that you're applying to. Often as med students, we kind of have this laser focus on going to the best place with the best reputation. And it's not really about that. It's about finding a place where people are happy and you can see yourself being happy as well.
Part of what makes Stanford so unique is that they truly embrace innovation. As a resident here, I have a very unique opportunity to participate in world-class cutting-edge research. But really, the biggest strength that I've only begun to appreciate once I was here and working as a resident is the people at Stanford.
My co-residents are amazing. One of the things after taking call with my class is that you truly get to kind of see people just step up and cover each other whenever someone gets sick or when something comes up. Everyone just unselfishly tries to step in for each other.
One of the unique things about radiology in particular is that the people in the field are very focused on family and making sure that we're healthy outside of work and that we have a good life balance. At Stanford, I've had nothing but support, which is amazing.
The relationships that I've formed here are extremely valuable to me, and I'm incredibly grateful for the colleagues that I work with, that I learn from on a daily basis, and they continue to inspire me. And quite frankly, we have a lot of fun.
I think the biggest shock for me, for radiology in particular, is that it's all new. So as a med student, you get very little exposure. So you're kind of starting all over again when you start your first rotation. So you feel quite vulnerable because you don't know what's going on, you don't know how to read the studies. And I think that is difficult, but at the same time, everyone here at Stanford understands that. And there was never a point in my training early on that I felt uncomfortable with the situation or that I didn't have enough support to make sure I was learning and at the same time making sure the patients were safe.
You are working directly one-on-one with your attendings and your staffing out, kind of asking for advice along the way from your fellows and co-residents also in the room. It's really great to have that one-on-one feedback. When I was first starting out, the attendings had spent a lot more time going through like basic anatomy, making sure that we go through each case in a very methodical way.
That was one of the major strength I noticed at Stanford right away, even as a med student, that you come to this place that has this amazing name and this amazing reputation, and the people are very down to earth. They're very friendly, they're very collegial. We speak on a first name basis.
Coming from the South, we're a bit more formal. That was something I really had to get used to. You know, you could go to some other places where you have people who are leaders in their field, but the ability to actually interact with them on a personal level is something I think that's pretty unique here.
As a resident here, I have a very unique opportunity to participate in world-class cutting-edge research, including clinical trials of novel radiopharmaceuticals for both diagnosis and non-invasive treatment of cancer, for example. In fact, it's often more a matter of picking and choosing what your particular interest is and which projects you'd like to pursue.
It's not every department that has 3 working PET MRI scanners for both clinical and research usage. I was able to really easily introduce myself into numerous high-level impactful research projects since being here, which is something I don't think I would have been able to accomplish at many other places. I was also drawn by the fact that there's kind of a significant diversity and complexity of pathology that comes to Stanford. We also are really leading in terms of utilizing dual energy CT. So that is kind of adding a new layer of complexity to all our CT scans that many residents aren't seeing anywhere else in the country. For instance, in a trauma patient, you can actually now see marrow edema from a fracture on a CT scan, which previously was only relegated to MRI. And that's something I see on call here. It's really quite amazing.
Living in Bavaria is lovely because of the weather that we get year-round. We have so many hiking trails nearby. And Stanford itself also has a lot of recreational opportunities, their pools or their gyms, and we all get access to that as well as residents.
My wife and I, when we moved, we were initially apprehensive about moving all the way across the country. And however, the support that we gained right away from everyone here in the department really helped us to feel at home. And we absolutely love the California lifestyle. This is a beautiful place to live. We really enjoy the outdoors, and the quality of life is absolutely fantastic.
I did med school in Boston, and I was there during the polar vortex. The snow was there until June, and you come to California and you're out in your t-shirt and your shorts with your family at the park, and you can really spend the majority of your time outdoors, hiking or going to the beach, and that's something that's very unique to this area.
We don't expect you to know any radiology knowledge. So just coming in hungry to learn, to see as many cases as you can, and to talk to as many people about any questions you might have.
Think carefully about your vision for the future of your field and your career, and what sort of place will best help you accomplish your goals and achieve that vision. And keep in mind that the strongest asset of your residency program will very likely be the people and the colleagues that you train with. So I would say keep an open mind, and if your experience is anything like mine, when you find the right place, you'll know it, and there'll be no doubt.